I'm Eric Johnson. I have the pleasure of being the department head over many amazing teachers in social studies at 5A High School. I grew up locally in West Pasco. As a young man, I decided to study accounting. My first degree was in accounting, and then quickly came to realize that being in an office wasn't suited for me. So I joined the Marine Corps, spent 5 years in the Marine Corps, was temporarily assigned to special operations. I was a hearse master, which was a wonderful time, and then unfortunately fell off a cliff and broke my back in Japan, training for an operation, which the Lord used. So I came back, spent 2 years in physical therapy, learning how to walk again. That was fun. And once I was able to walk again, looked like I was gonna stay in the Marine Corps, but unfortunately was in a car accident. Spent another year in physical therapy, and then went to Bible college, because I decided as I went back to college, I was gonna study something I knew I would use. So I have a 4-year degree in pastoral studies from Trinity Bible College. Was a youth pastor, decided I wanted to transition into teaching in the public schools, so I went back to USF and got a master's in US history. I don't believe in just teaching out of the book. I think that we need to extend the classroom beyond the books, so we've started doing special projects. Recently, one of our projects was the humanitarian aid to Haiti. I'd been teaching about tectonic plate movement and geography at the same time that the earthquake hit, and many of the students wanted to know what we could do, or if we could do something to help people in another country. So we took the Red Cross needs list and our school approved items list, cross-referenced them, and came up with a list of items for students to donate. We thought it'd be a small project, but in the time of about 2 or 3 days, Morton Plant Mies, the Spring Hill Eye Institute, had contacted us, and we had truckloads of medical equipment donated. So then the students asked how we would get it to Haiti, expecting to send a box I hadn't actually prepared. But we were able to charter a World War II cargo plane, and we used an old World War II cargo plane to take about 10 tons worth of medical supplies to Haiti. And then when I got there, we emptied them into a dump truck to get them to the clinics in the mountains. It was an amazing experience. We took video footage while I was there. And then when I came back, my students used that video footage to do a documentary. It's a 4-minute documentary that we have sent out to the other high schools since to demonstrate that the kids here in Hudson, Florida can affect the world. Last year, we took a trip to New York. I took 50 students up and down the East Coast. We spent 7 days traveling up and down the East Coast. We had an invitation to come to the White House. So we got to go to the White House. Some of the kids got to meet the First Lady. It was a wonderful time. We also visited the Smithsonian in Washington, D.C. Several of the memorials. We took a night illuminated tour. Then we stopped in New York City, where we visited Ground Zero. That's part of another project we did with some fire hydrants in commemoration of the firefighters and police officers who both sacrificed themselves there and continue to make sacrifices today of their personal safety. So we visited Ground Zero, the Statue of Liberty, the Metropolitan Museum. It was an amazing time, Times Square, of course. And then on the way back, we stopped at Mount Vernon, George Washington's Boyhood Plantation, and Colonial Williamsburg. Was extremely exciting because it's over 80 acres and 120 buildings with actors in costumes from the period. So the students really got to see many of the places that we've been studying about. We stopped in Gettysburg on that trip, and the kids got to see the battlefield and the town of Gettysburg. And we were studying social history. What did the city go through? What did the women go through? Because we always make sure that we touch on gender history. So it was an amazing trip, and it actually won second in the nation for the PBS Innovative Teaching Award. So as a teacher, I have the opportunity to share with the students the value of education. And I find that many of our down-to-earth students, you know, they're just average people, that when they understand the value of education, they put more time into their work. They turn in more of their homework. I get a much higher participation rate once the students understand that it does pay to do well in school, not just through a sense of satisfaction and accomplishment, but that those good grades translate into scholarships, and those scholarships translate into a college education they might not have been able to obtain without that assistance. So if they can leave my classroom understanding and utilizing their fullest potential so that they can go off and be positive, constructive members of our community, then I think I've done an amazing job. The most important thing that I've learned also takes me to one of the most embarrassing stories that I've had in teaching, and that was during the Katrina hurricane and flooding. I was teaching honors economics, so I was teaching human capital and the cost in human life, as well as insurance claims and property damage. And a student in the back of the class became upset So I let her know that she could go to the library if it was upsetting her. And she came back after class, which demonstrates the caliber of student she was. And I told her we'd be watching the coverage the next day because it was important. And I asked her why it was upsetting her so much, and she shared that her grandfather was an Alzheimer's victim and that he had been in a resident home in New Orleans and they had not been able to locate him. So I very quickly felt very small. And I went home later that evening and was speaking to my wife, and I got on Assembler and I found the young lady's phone number because I felt as if I needed to call the home and apologize. And the family shared that they still had not found the grandfather, at which point I offered to go to New Orleans and find him, which seemed odd at first. But you have to understand, after I got in the Marine Corps, I spent 2 years doing private security globally, and I actually had an assault craft in my garage. So I loaded up my dive gear, I'm a rescue diver, and went to New Orleans and spent 2 weeks working in New Orleans, pulling people from the water. We did 127 rescues, 96 of the people survived. So that was an amazing experience. I actually got interviewed by CNN, and my students were watching the current events that week and got to see me be interviewed by CNN. And her grandfather actually ended up getting moved to Texas. He had been evacuated, but since he was an Alzheimer's victim, he didn't know where he was and was confused. But when I came back, the kids and I got to spend a great deal of time discussing the importance of being sensitive. So as a teacher, I learned not to be too jaded and not to just quickly assume what the relationships are between our students and current events and different disasters. And that's been reinforced recently with the 10-year anniversary of 9/11. Instead of just speaking to the issue, I asked my students who had connections, who had family. I had a young lady who had lost an aunt, another student whose father had been a paramedic, another student whose uncle had been a first responder firefighter, and he actually volunteered and came in and spoke to our students at the school. So just to be sensitive to students. And I just want to thank the students and the staff and the employees and the parents of Pasco County for taking a broken down old soldier and giving me the chance to work with the kids.